I am delighted to share the good parts of a recent expedition to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico, a timeshare condominium I acquired several years ago. I've visited this facility 8 times now and will return. I had the really great fortune of traveling with Tanya Rogers on this particular trip, a longtime traveling companion to Costa Rica and Alaska, for that matter. The hotel itself is superbly executed, beautifully decorated. The bougainvillea flowers grace every single porch, and every unit has a porch. The landscaping within the condominium complex is superb. Beautifully manicured, replete with a huge variety of gorgeous plants. The ocean itself, beautiful, clear, clean beach, no rocks, no hazards. Protected by the outer bay. This Puerto Vallarta itself is located in inland waters. It's not subject to massive storms as the outer Pacific coast would be. All manner of things to do here. These parasailing, gosh, you can step back and design and build sandcastles. All manner of sailing and water sport opportunities are available. Sayulita, a town about 20 miles away around on the Pacific Ocean side, renowned for its surfing capability. It does attract the surfing crowd, somewhat akin to the concept of a hippie gang, but wonderful people having a wonderful time. The town itself is pretty congested, lots of tourists there when we were there. Around the corner, a mile or two down the road, almost remote beach. We had this water to ourselves. And the silence and peace of the ocean environment we very much welcomed. Not a swimming opportunity here. Get yourself banged up on the rocks pretty seriously. All manner of marine life. Time to reflect, to appreciate, and to observe. That spiritual, emotional, intellectual connection with the ocean is something I have cherished all of my years. I was delighted to have Tanya clearly enjoy being with the ocean as much as she did. I can watch ocean waves break and recede for hours at a time, meditative, that's peace and silence in my own mind. The road trip from Puerto Vallarta, from Velas Vallarta Hotel to Boca, about an hour's drive along the coast. The road then cuts up into the mountains. Boca serves as the takeoff point for water transportation to all of the facilities west and along the southern coast of the bay. Our first stop was at the Verona Spa up on a ridge overlooking the bay where the town of Jalapa is located. This is a superb facility. I have visited this numerous times. It is an upscale resort. You can stay for 4 or 5 or more days. The restaurant is a 5-star, absolutely exquisite cuisine. The spa treatments themselves I find to be absolutely top-notch. You can rent a mule to get up there, but we chose to use a shoe leather express. Series of isolated homes, each uniquely built, creative architecture and very functional. Much period art. And the spa and restaurant location itself is as exquisitely executed as the rest of the masonry work about the facility. The town of Yalapa, out in the distance off to the right a bit, does have access to a waterfall up at the half a mile up the river, so well worth the walk. The beach itself is plied with vendedores and fresh seafood, different operations there. The boat landing at the base of the Verona Spa has populated with hundreds of these agile jumping crabs. These guys are really fun to watch. They seem to play and cavort and fight over territory, as one would expect.
Have you ever seen that?
No, I've never seen that before.
I saw skates jumping out of the water. Never seen that happen before. We missed, there were 8 or 10 of them, but it's tough to catch them. They don't come up on a regular basis. Back to Velas Vallarta, feet up, sunshine, peace, solitude, relatively quiet. It wasn't overcrowded at this point in time.
Ready for
relaxation,
dinner. Almost.
Sense of ease is exquisite. From here, more often than not, you see the sun set into the ocean.
A schooner.
Gorgeous scenery. The ocean itself has so much allure in my mind. The years I've spent near and on the ocean have been very good years. Not a good idea to point a digital camera at the sun, but this is fading out and I couldn't help but get the last wink of the day as it dropped below the horizon.
Nope.
The Boca, again at the end of the oceanside part of the road, serves as the takeoff point for marine transportation to dozens of facilities, private, public, large, small, permanent homes, getaway.
Great summer today.
Was delighted to watch the local fishermen prepare their catch. Timing didn't come out right. I really wanted to have one of these fillets for lunch, but didn't quite make it. Preparing this fish properly, about ready to salt it.
Sea salt.
Apparently you cannot put too much salt on seafood. I try to stay away from excess myself, but brings out the flavor. Bed of coals and a setup through experience. How hot does the fire have to be? How close does the fish go? I'm sure this works out perfectly well.
Negative. Below zero.
Oh, my God.
Preparing shrimp skewer to roast shrimp in the same manner that the snappers are being roasted.
That place up there is for sale if you want to buy it.
The
quasi-public transportation, the water taxis operated by licensed boatmen, good solid fiberglass craft, are essential for transportation in this area. There are no roads again.
How long will it take them to build?
Quite a collection of architectural styles that again, in the Bay of Bandidos, protected, not subject to the storm surf that the outer Pacific would be. Couldn't get away with putting a house on the rocks like that and the potential of hurricane storms. Classic architecture, thatch roofs. Beto and Pamela are gave us opportunity to see life in Quimixto, a small town. With no road access, had a really attractive waterfall. This is interpreted via a horseback expedition. You can walk up there, but riding the horses provides an extra bit of variety. Nothing wrong with sipping on a Corona whilst driving a horse. Beto insisted that the mules were probably more intelligent than the mule operators. The trail to the waterfall, chopped up by the horse hoofs and eroded subsequently by rains, turned into be quite of a canyon. It was a challenge to pass a horse coming the other way, but it happened well enough as was necessary. Hola!
Hello!
Beto and Pamela did not ride horses.
We'll
cross the river to the restaurant waterfall facility.
Gracias, Beto. There's Tanya.
We did stop at one little cove where Beto had managed to attract fish, tossing a handful of bread in. We got the angelfish to come up along with dozens of other gorgeously colored tropical species, right up close and personal with a mask and snorkel. The town of Yalapa, quite a combination of activities here, the restaurant, there are hotels and good hiking facilities. Fresh raw oysters, the highlight as far as I'm concerned from a culinary point of view. I absolutely love these things. There was frequently a good view of the pirate ship, which was not endowed with an aggressive crew. We did not see on this particular trip the humpback whales, the young, and the activities. But that's often very, very possible happening. Marty and Tanya and Pamela, good time. Really nothing quite like visiting the tropics when it's 20 below zero back home. This respite is something I welcome. I have love this place every time I visit it. I want to go back, and I will very soon.